Hello, welcome back for part two of episode 31, The Long and the Short of Things. In the garden, two other males have shown up, and Brownie has gone into hiding. Brownie, maybe feeling outnumbered, has chosen to stay out of sight for now. One of the males, this one, appears to be Rover, the former leader of the garden, until Brownie moved in. The other male has now moved down to the far end of the log across the pond. For the moment, he doesn't seem to want any trouble and gives Rover his space. Again, I have to question, where is Brownie? He should be here defending his turf. Oh well, as the old saying goes, while the cat's away, the mice will play. In this case, these mice are roving male anoles. But will any of the garden females give these guys the time of day? Meanwhile, in the backyard, Adama and the rest of the chain gang find themselves with some company. Another young male anole, looking for love, has entered the territory. It's hard to be sure, since I haven't seen him in so long, but this looks like Apollo. Well, whoever he is, he's sure full of himself. As he showboats down, I can see, like many of the other lizards here in the alley, he's missing a good chunk of his tail. He dances up and down the handrail. Surely, this will get someone's attention. It does. Little sister has come out to see what he's up to. She has just mated with the admiral. It's probably too soon for her to mate again, especially with a stranger. Of course, this stranger isn't going to let that stand in his way. He believes he still stands a good chance at a date with her. She does move closer to check him out. Then again, I could be wrong. She may allow a mating. But as he makes his way up to the rail, she takes evasive action. This doesn't stop his advances. After a tense few moments, my original theory holds true. She heads in the opposite direction. She gives him a polite warning and leaves him in her dust. Driven by his overwhelming hormones and his desire to pass along his genes into the next generation, he doesn't give up the chase. He continues to pursue her. S- sister, finds her safe spot near the window. Leaving her unwanted suitor hanging in the breeze. Finally, the Admiral comes to her rescue. Just the sight of Adama is enough to send the young male running. He disappears down into the dead leaves of the plants, burned to a crisp by the relentless hot summer sun. Still, no rainfall here in the alley. We're in a severe drought. After taking care of the roving male, Adama can now relax and breathe a little easier and continue to enjoy his dominance. It's a short break. Again, someone else shows up to threaten his world. Leo! We all know he's been hiding out close by. Now, he's returned, hopefully prepared to try the Admiral. Well, maybe. But this time, he wasn't prepared enough. The Admiral is on him in a flash. Poor Leo. He's forced to retreat, hiding down in the boardwalk. Adama is up to his game. And Leo just isn't quite ready to take him on. He chases Leo away, back into the bushes. Fortunately, Leo escapes with only a bruised ego. That's okay. At least he has somewhere to go. The old air conditioner. Home for the time being. Adama had better not step back here. I continue to look for Brownie in the garden. I've yet to find him. In the meantime, I stop to enjoy a few of the lilies. The white ones are Easter lilies. The orange ones, wild daylilies. I still can't find Brownie. Were the others successful with their attempt at a takeover? Find out in part 3.